Well, good morning, everybody. My name is Tony Grillo, and I don't know if you can see DJ. There he is. There's DJ. Today I'm in Wrightstown, Wisconsin at M&M Cold Storage. They built this brand new facility right behind me. And just bringing a load of frozen vegetables that I picked up out of Minnesota. And am delivering here to this place. So I came across a really fascinating story that happened. I live in Wisconsin, and I try to do a lot of Wisconsin stories here. And this one caught my attention, and involves a mayor, a police chief, and a lady that worked in the office for the city of Amery, Wisconsin. And something happened over there in the past couple weeks of Amery. It's quite a story. If you guys haven't heard about it, I just found out about it today, but apparently this story's been going on for a couple weeks now. I just found out about it on YouTube, of all places. I'm going to talk about it on my YouTube channel because I think it's a fascinating story, and it happens in my state of Wisconsin. Real quick, I'm going to show you where Amery is on the map here in Wisconsin. We have the town here. There's some pictures to the left. And I'm going to zoom out so you can get an idea where Amery is. But Amery is not very far from Turtle Lake and St. Croix Falls. Turtle Lake has a casino there. Come here. And if we zoom out some more, you can see that it's like just northeast of Minneapolis and St. Paul. And it's like northwest of Eau Claire and Chippewa Falls. So I thought I'd check out, before I get into the story, I'd check out the Amery, Wisconsin word of mouth. We post anything and kind of get a look at what some of the people there in Amery do. Let's just kind of look at some of their stuff. So here's somebody that's advertising Mark's Mobile Glass. Here's somebody that's talking about air duct cleaning, which I actually probably need that done on my own. And then we have a tumble in the jungle childcare. Here somebody posted that they have a free desk right there if anyone's interested in Amery. Here's a cute little cat that was found. They're looking for a nice home. And this is the post that I wanted to share with all of you because I thought it was interesting. Danny Kundra, she says that I've been in Wisconsin for 6 months. I turned 35 this month. New life, new friends. I want to do something spectacular for my birthday, of which I haven't celebrated for years, related to life circumstances. Please give me your favorite things to do in Wisconsin that would make for an epic birthday. I moved from Missouri, if that makes a difference, and I don't drink. So let's see what the people there of Amery tell her to do. I know if it was my post, I would go kayaking down the St. Croix River, and then there's a fun outdoor art museum I like to go hit, and then I would probably catch a band somewhere in that area. There's lots of bands that perform, especially with summer going on. There's every town seems to have a summer festival, so and that would be my idea of a really good time. But let's see what these people have to say. Go tubing down one of the many beautiful rivers Minneapolis, get a hotel and club hop. Only way to go. Yep. What do you do? Enjoy. What do you enjoy? Outdoors, indoors, fishing, gaming? And she replied, I love being in nature. Let's see what she replied as. I love being in nature, museums, concerts, animal, kind of learning what I like all over again. And somebody said shooting. Okay, zipline at Trollhagen. Or hot air balloon on Stillwater. Oh, yeah. You always see the hot air balloons going in and out of Stillwater. That would actually be pretty cool. And I did not know. I have actually skied at Trollhagen back when I was a kid. I didn't know they had a zipline there now. Okay. Adventure course and zipline at Trollhagen. All right. Wonderful state and national parks abound in Wisconsin. Yeah, yeah. When I mentioned kayaking down St. Croix River, that is at a state park. That's right there. It's right on the border of Minnesota and Wisconsin. I forgot the name of that town. Oh, okay. So, take a boat ride out of Stillwater? Yeah, you could do that. I have actually done boat rides on Wisconsin. Somebody said Wisconsin Dells. Yeah, that's a good place to go. Wisconsin Dells is back where, it's kind of by, towards where I live. So from where she lives, by Minneapolis, St. Paul, it would probably be a good, probably 2.5 hour drive, I believe. But yeah, Willow River State Park in Hudson, and the beautiful falls there. Yep, that's a great place to go too. And hot air balloon ride or skydiving. Okay, yeah. So this was back in 2016, back when I was, I'd lost a lot of weight back then, and I was very, very skinny. I need to get back to that size again. But I went out kayaking with this friend of mine that I've known for quite a long time, and we're just friends. That's all we ever were. That's all that there ever was. She was going through a divorce at the time, and she just wanted to go out and have fun. And so I took her to one of the funnest places I know, which is out there by Amery.
Kayaking. Hello, everybody. It's hard to kayak and hold the phone at the same time. Gorgeous day. A lot of people out here.
Yeah, I sure would like to go back there again. I'm hoping to take Elizabeth there one of these days. These were some of the pictures that I took. Oops. Yeah, this is at Taylor's Falls, Minnesota. Oops. Keep hitting that wrong button. But just gorgeous, gorgeous water. That's where I would go. Was Melissa there kayaking. I think it was her first time she ever went. Same with me, as a matter of fact. I just see some of the beautiful scenery there. I'll show maybe one or two more pictures. I gotta get going with this video. There she was kayaking ahead of me. Yeah, this is the park we are at. Interstate Park. Park entrance. We are here, and then the St. Croix River right there. We are paddling. Right there where it said paddling. So this is the mayor of Amery. His name is Chad Leonard. And he just posted his resignation like last week. And I'll read what he has to say about that. And this is the chief of police at Amery. His name is Steve Hansel, and he also resigned. So I'm going to read what this article by Jimmy Casca, dated July 7th, 2023, so it wasn't that long ago. Mayor Amery, chief of police, and mayor stepped down in the same week. Several social media posts about the two now former city leaders have racked up tens and even hundreds of thousands of views. Amery, Wisconsin, this is from WLAK, must be a radio station, reports that the city of Amery will be seeking new leadership in two key positions after this week. Steve Hansel, the chief of police, abruptly retired on Monday, which was accepted by the Amery City Council on Wednesday. On Thursday morning, Amery's mayor, Chad Leonard, sent his resignation to the city council and city administrator, Patty Bjorklund. Hansel was the subject of several viral social media posts that alleged he and his wife were making pornographic videos. Hansel denied those claims in his retirement letter, saying that his wife's work as a bikini model was being used as an attack against his character. He cited intolerable conditions in his letter and said that a lack of communication as well as misinformation led his decision to step down after only 5 months on the job. Now, I looked up the population of Amery, Wisconsin. It's a town, little town of about 3,000 people. So you got 3,000 people there, and usually it's a pretty quiet town. Most towns in Wisconsin are that way, a small town. And usually everybody knows everybody, and usually most people get along. So for, you know, and usually the chief and the mayor, I mean, the mayor, he ran unopposed in his last couple elections. So pretty much, you know, once you get a position there, you're pretty much there for the rest of your life. You have to really screw up big time in order for the people to all of a sudden get ticked off at you. And even Wisconsin people are super nice. They tend to be a forgiving lot. So, you know, you have to screw up big time in order for there to be a public uproar, and the town demands that you leave now. So here's why, what brought this all on, okay? And we'll get to that here, but last month, Hansel's firing of Bethany Escrow, the Amery Police Department's administrative assistant, was overturned by the city council in a 4-1 vote. Hansel fired Escrow for her role in making social media posts critical of the city's government and employees. Okay, we'll get to that in a moment. She actually did not post critical stuff, but she did give out public information that allowed somebody else to write a critical post about the chief, and I'll get to what exactly that post was. We'll take a look at that as well. But the police chief was upset, and he basically called her in as part of an internal investigation, and which was pretty bogus because she didn't break any laws, and he basically fired her because he said her actions caused a uproar among the concerned citizens. Yeah, well, he got embarrassed is what happened. He got caught lying is the bottom line. He got caught lying on his job application and on his resume, okay? He said he was qualified for some training that he apparently supposedly got, and then he was called out for it because in the budget meeting, apparently he had requested money from the city to pay for some training, and somebody questioned that and said, well, on your resume, you said you already had that training. So you lied on your resume. So what else are you lying about? And he got caught. He got caught lying on his resume. and he was ticked off about it. And, you know, she made that information public to the guy, and the guy, whoever put the post up, was critical of the chief, and he was, he got caught lying, and he tried to fire her as retaliation, and it backfired in his face, and as a result, the town got really upset, and there must have been such a huge uproar that he was forced to quit. He had to resign. He said retired, but he had to resign. He had to leave. So, yeah, his retirement was accepted unanimously by the town board there, and effective on July 10th, and the city will not have an acting police chief, but instead will begin searching for a new police chief. And they're also advertising for a full-time police officer. All right, let's read what the mayor had to say, because right up here was also a press release that said from Patty Bjork Lund. She basically said that on Thursday, July 6th, she received a resignation letter from Mayor Chad Leonard. And so this is the story about that. The morning after Hansel's retirement was accepted, Amery Mayor Chad Leonard's resignation letter was received by the city council and city administrator, and in his resignation letter, Leonard wrote that he was disappointed that the loudest voices were being heard and not necessarily for the best interests of the community. Well, yeah, you got a chief of police that lied about his resume, lied about training that he supposedly told everybody he had and that he didn't have. And the mayor was the one that hired him. And so, you know, why didn't the mayor look into his background a little better, you know? And when you got a chief that's lying about stuff, you know, then his credibility comes into, you know, character. And now he's lost all credibility. And so, yeah, you know, the what else is he lying about? That's what people want to know. So this is Steve Hansel's wife, and apparently she, I don't know what YouTube, she had a social media site. I don't know if it was OnlyFans, I don't know if she was on some other site, but maybe you subscribe to her site, and apparently she was posing with pictures of very provocative clothes on, or you know, things of that nature. Some have claimed that her site was pornographic. Now, the chief denies that he was never in any of her videos and that they didn't do anything, you know, pornographic on her website. But apparently her, with all the uproar that's been going on over the chief and his conduct and his firing of an administrative assistant who basically, you know, called him out on his lies, well, she was a part of it. She wasn't the actual one that did it, but she supplied the info. She took a hit too, and apparently now nobody's looking at her website anymore. So this was the Facebook group. They call themselves City Watchers. It's a private group. Well, apparently I can't get the information I want from them. All right, so we're going to go here to back to Amery, Wisconsin, word of mouth. And here we go. Amery friends, did you know that the city of Amery recently held a hostile workplace interrogation of an employee because the city thought they were city watcher? This employee was terminated because of a closed session notice being posted to the bulletin board in City Hall. They are legally required to post these notices. The city claimed this employee leaked confidential information, which I then posted. Nothing I posted was false information. The city is requiring the new police chief who lied about their qualifications to take classes on the police department's budget. This takes from actual patrol hours, training, equipment, etc., all because one man was too proud to admit he did not qualify for the job. You've seen claims about the paper delivery crew being harassed and members of the community laughing it off. This did happen. The police chief made no effort to work with them. Now employees are fired for telling secrets. Well, here's a secret you could see for yourself by walking to the bulletin board. There is a notice for an open session meeting tomorrow night at 5 in the council meeting room to discuss the information that was printed by the editor of the newspaper. The city tried to hide it by forcing it to be a closed session, but one of the terminated employees is standing up for themselves, demanding it to be an open session, as is their right. What if police department did shoddy investigations and wrongfully accused people of crimes through coercion to try getting them to admit to something they didn't do? The Department of Justice would be at their door, and this is against the U.S. Constitution. If you don't think it's a big deal, you aren't paying attention to the events taking place in our world due to bad leadership, worse, unqualified leadership. I am not, nor have I ever been employed by the city of Amery. Through threat and intimidation, the city terminated the employee without just cause. This isn't an anti-police post by any means. It is anti-unqualified people holding power post. In a way, you are as much of a city watcher as me. We are watching injustices that need to be righted. Show up today for five for the meeting and learn about what your elected and appointed officials are trying to hide for you, from you, you know? And so that was the post there. Ethics Board seals complaints against Amery Mayor and the city administrator. Okay, so here it was. Ethics complaints filed against Mayor Chad Leonard and City Administrator Patty Bjorklund will remain confidential. Interesting. So the Amery Ethics Board, which handles internal complaints with city staff, has sealed two ethics complaints that were the subject of closed session of the Amery City Council in March and April. All right, so what is really interesting here is that, this employee was terminated, and there is video of this discussion that went on, this police interrogation, and so we will take a look at that. I thought she had been booted off social media, but here she is, the chief of Amery, chief of police wife. Her husband for his fine. So before I get into the actual interrogation, I thought I would show you, this is Bethany Escrow. And there was this GoFundMe page that has started up for her by a Megan Olson. Apparently 28 donations she's gotten, and they've raised $1,030 for her. Help fight for free speech in Amery, Wisconsin. Okay, so the video that I'm playing for you came from this website, Junebug77, and I got it from another YouTube channel called San Joaquin Valley Transparency. And so let's take a quick look at it.
Sort of. Welcome back to San Joaquin Valley Transparency. On May 11, 2023, Police Chief Steve Hainzel interrogated an Amery City employee named Bethany Escrow, who works in his office, for taking a photograph of a publicly posted city council agenda and texting it to friends. The chief then investigated a non-crime by investigating the person who criticized him and the local government on a Facebook post. Here's that post. Exactly 1 week earlier, on May 4th, 2023, Chief Steve Hainzel received a phone call from the city clerk treasurer, Ben Jansen, who brought to the chief's attention about the City Watcher's Facebook post. The post read, "So please tell me why the Amery police chief is taking professionalism classes that the police department is paying for out of their regular budget, when he lied on his resume and said that he had those."
Hey, I apologize. My Wi-Fi is not working too well. I'm in another town called Oakdale, Wisconsin, which is right by Toma, and it's coming in pretty fuzzy, and I'm trying to finish this video. I only have a couple minutes left.
He had those skills, along with stating that if you paid taxes in Amery, Wisconsin, this should outrage you. Immediately, Chief Hainzel was outraged and began his bogus investigation. And this is when he began interrogating Bethany Escrow.
All right. So, informing you that you're being investigated for internal investigation, right, for violation of policy. So, here is your. You can read that and sign that, and I will sign that for you as well. Okay. So this was brought to my attention about some posts that were on Facebook and stuff. So I have to ask, did you take any photos of the Common Council agenda?
Yes, I took a photo.
Okay. And why did you do that?
I like to see them and have them available.
Okay.
They're public.
Okay.
It's public information.
Okay, yeah, I understand that. And what did you do with that photo?
On my phone.
Saw it on your phone?
Yep.
You didn't give it to anybody else?
If somebody asked me what was happening with what the Common Council agenda was, I sent it to them.
Okay, and who did you send it to?
I'm sure some friends.
Well, I need to know who those friends are. Who did you send it to?
I don't. You need to know
who you sent that photo to.
Something that is public knowledge that I sent privately off duty.
Okay, well, it's. The photo to discredit the department. So, and also, this is Common Council in the city. So, are you refusing to answer and tell me who you sent this photo to?
I don't believe that I did anything wrong.
I didn't ask that. Please. So are you refusing to tell me who you sent this photo to?
I sent the photo to friends who asked about.
So she didn't do anything wrong. She didn't break any laws. She took a picture of the Common Council agenda. And, you know, so if she didn't break any laws, then it shouldn't matter who she sent it to. She could send it to anybody, but this guy is obviously on a fishing trip. He's ticked off. He wants to find out the identity of this person known as CTY. because they've been, you know, posting stuff on Facebook severely criticizing the police chief and the police department. And he wants to know the identity of this person, because I'm sure he wants to know who it is that's, you know, saying these things about him that are derogatory but yet true. Because he did lie on his job resume, and that was something he didn't want to get out to the public.
Okay, who asked about the common council?
I have plenty of friends asked about it. Members of the public asked about the common council.
Okay. Who did you send that photo to?
I don't believe I need to give any names to people.
Okay. Well, what was your intention on giving that photo?
She didn't do anything wrong, so she doesn't have to give that information, because she didn't break any laws. So she doesn't have to tell the chief who she sent the picture to.
I have no intentions on giving that photo.
No intentions on giving this photo to this person, right? That's your photo, is it, or no?
Who says it's my photo?
Is this the photo that you took here?
Yeah, that's the photo I took.
This is the photo, this actual photo here, the one from here. You took that photo. Okay. And who did you give this photo?
So, her photo of the council agenda minutes appeared on a post that the police chief didn't like. And he does not know the identity of the person that is saying these things about the police department in Amery. Is it Amery or Amery? Amery, Wisconsin. And this goes on like this for a while. So I'm going to I'll show a little bit more of this. Okay, so she asked him, am I being fired? And he said, well, I'm still continuing the investigation. I got other things I got to check on. Why don't you go back to your desk and finish up your duties? At that point, she felt extremely uncomfortable being in that office with him. And she just felt like, I've just been grilled here for something. I didn't break any laws, and this guy is interrogating me. And I'm going to leave. I'm going to get out of here because I just don't feel comfortable here anymore in a hostile work environment and being grilled by an angry police chief because he doesn't like criticism. That's true. And so she tells him, I'm leaving. You can talk to my lawyer. And then he watch what he does next.
This video is not over, folks. The chief is about to fire her. She handled herself extremely well with integrity. Check this out, folks, and keep watching because there's a happy ending here.
That's also ordering not to text talk about it. Are you leaving? Okay, well, okay, you're being terminated right now then. Okay, I need your ID, and I need you to sign this here. Let me give your stuff here. your copy? You're refusing to sign. This is your... Where's your key? Excuse me, I'm not done talking. Out where? I need to see where. Where is it? Where's your ID? Here's a copy of your investigation. Here's your copy of your investigation. And this is your right to appeal. Would you like to sign that you have a right to... I have to sign this here. That you have a right to appeal. Well, let me make a copy of that for you as well.
So now the chief is being grilled, I think, by some kind of attorney who, via I don't know, FaceTime or whatever, however they do it on, it's kind of interesting to see, you know, the guy that was harassing the female worker, all of a sudden now he's getting harassed by a lawyer.
I can sign documents, yes.
Do you believe the court is going to believe you after your testimony here today?
Yes.
Okay. Because again, you didn't sign this document, but you're willing to sign this document that contains false statements made by you, right?
Not false statements.
Well, you don't know whether or not Ms. Escrow made a false statement. And you never have known that, right?
I assume that, yes.
Right. So if you were to sign your name to this document, that would be false, wouldn't it?
Yeah, he is totally right. I mean, he's just assuming, you know, that this his investigation that Bethany Escrow sent the picture agenda minutes to a guy that was criticizing him, but he has absolutely no evidence to back that statement up. But yet he put it in a report, but then he didn't sign the report for reasoning for her termination, which he called insubordination. And so this lawyer is just really doing a great job of you know, peppering this guy, telling him, you know, you can't even sign your own report because it's not truthful. You just got, you know, even he said, I assumed. Well, assumptions aren't, you know, what's that saying? When you assume something, it makes an ass out of you and me. He has no evidence. He has no evidence that Bethany did anything wrong.
Because I believe it's the totality of circumstances that she did those.
All you have left, sir, is a video camera of Miss Escrow taking a picture of a public document in a public place. Isn't that right?
That's one aspect of the evidence.
What else you got left?
That she correlated and enabled this person with the city watcher. And
you've admitted that you can't sustain that. And you've admitted it several times, haven't you?
I guess so.
So if you...
Yeah, you know, when you're a police chief, that looks really bad when you got to say, I guess so. You know, I guess so. And you have no evidence to support any of the things that you said in your report. So basically, his termination of Bethany Escrow was bogus. He had no credible information that she did anything wrong. And the fact is that he did lie on his own resume.
Police administrative assistant.
I've had a lot of people write to me. I've had a lot of people approach me for conversations. I've also spent a lot of time in thought over the last several days. Primarily, I think that HR or some sort of third-party person should have been involved in this situation for the protection of both the city and for Ms. Escrow. I think that not having some sort of third-party person led to a lot of mishandling and made the water really muddy. It's also incredibly clear to me that we have some major trust issues between our new chief and his staff, and that's really, really disheartening to me because I'm extremely pro Amery Police Department, and I don't think that these trust issues are going to lead to productive police work in our city. So that's something that I think we really need to address.
So I don't get a vote, but I'd like to have at least a voice. A committee hired Steve to be the police chief. Yes, I appointed Steve to that position, and it was approved by this council.
So, you know, what I love about this video is that the man who misused his power and his authority and lied, and his cronies tried to cover up for him, they all got exposed by an assistant to the office of the sheriff. I mean, she must have seen all this stuff going on and thought, you know, I don't like what's going on here. And she, you know, she was a whistleblower. And, you know, generally I'm not, she did the right thing. You know, that's what she did. She did the right thing. And what's really satisfying about the whole story that went on in Amery, Wisconsin, I'm not against police officers. I was a volunteer firefighter for 20 years. I've worked with Dodge County Police and the Dodge County Sheriffs. You know, I worked with, you know, all the village police officers and all the townships, and, you know, and they're all good guys. We had good people there. But when you have an abuse of power, you know, it was so satisfying to see the little guy, or in this case, the little lady, actually win. She took them down. She took all of them down, the mayor and the police chief, and she took them all down. And she got a whole town cheering for her. And, you know, I would love it if she became the next mayor. Wouldn't that be something? I mean, that would, you know, we're just going to have to keep our eyes on what's going on over there in Amery, Wisconsin. But this video got awfully long, but there was so much to it to talk about in this video. And I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I did a pretty good job of putting it together. You know, I do put it together while I'm, you know, also at the same time I'm, you know, working, you know. So sometimes I, you know, I park the truck and I will work on it for like a half hour. And so sometimes I lose my train of thought or my place or what exactly how I want to do a video. And so hopefully I put it together in a entertaining way. And I think it's an awesome story. It happened here in Wisconsin. And so that's why I put it on my channel, trying to get the word out, because I hadn't heard about this story either. It's not getting a whole lot of media coverage, even in Wisconsin. I haven't heard a whole lot about it. So I thought, you know, I would put the word out as well, you know, even though my channel is very small. But, you know, even if 10 people hear it, then those 10 will tell another 10 people. And it just, that's how you get the word out about what's going on out there. All right, everybody. I hope you have a great rest of your week, and Wisconsin hugs.